guys, welcome back to my channel. So as usual, I'm priming my face with Hourglass's Mineral Veil Primer, and then I'm going in with Estee Lauder's Double Wear Foundation, and I'm applying this in the areas where I tend to get most oily, which is on my forehead and on my nose. And it's basically like the only foundation that actually stays in place throughout the day for me. And then I'm using Hourglass's Stick Foundation, and I'm applying that on my cheeks, and I'm blending that out with a synthetic brush. Since this is a cream product, you want to make sure that you buff it into the skin really nicely. And I love this foundation because once it's blended out, it actually looks like your skin. And as usual, I'm going in with my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, and I'm going to use this to highlight, and I'm going underneath my eyes, on my forehead, and on my chin. And after all of that is blended, I'm gonna go in with my Laura Mercier translucent powder, and I'm just using that to set my concealer so that it doesn't crease. And to set the rest of my face, I'm gonna use my Makeup Forever Duo Matte Powder, and I'm just using patting motions to really lock that foundation in. And you wanna avoid swiping while you're setting your face, because then you're just gonna move all that foundation around. After priming my eyes, I'm going in with that warm brown shade in the Anastasia Renaissance palette, and I'm just blending that in my crease for a nice transition shade. Then I'm going in with that cranberry color, and I'm using that to deepen the crease even more. Then I'm taking that darker brown shade to blend in my inner and outer corner of my eye. Then I'm going to connect those corners together, making sure that this shade doesn't go above my transition colors. Taking a clean blending brush, I'm just gonna keep blending until I don't see any harsh lines. Then I'm taking that Becca bronzer and just applying that color on my lid. Then I'm taking this beautiful Stila liquid shadow. It's super pigmented, and I love it because it has lots of glitter without the fallout. And I'm just using that on my lid so that it pops even more. Taking that same cranberry shade, I'm using that to blend it on my lower lash line. Then, of course, I'm taking my favorite liquid liner by NYX, and I'm gonna finish it off with a cat eye. My favorite highlighter by Laura Geller. It's called Gilded Honey. I'm just applying that on my inner tear duct, then applying some lashes and mascara to finish the eyes off. To give my face some color, I'm going in with my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish and Give Me Sun, and I'm just warming up my cheekbones and my forehead. After warming up my face, I'm going in with this Dior contour powder to really carve out my cheekbones a little bit more to add some definition. And for a nice flush of color, I'm taking this NARS Peachy Pink blush and applying that on the apples of my cheeks. And to add more of that glow underneath my eyes, I'm applying my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. And I'm going back in with that Laura Geller highlighter to really concentrate this highlight on the highest point of my cheekbones. And I also like taking this product down the bridge of my nose and on the tip of my nose. And now I'm going to use my Kat Von D's lip stain in Bow and Arrow. This is just a nice matte nude, and it's super neutral. And then I'm topping it off with Dior's Lip Maximizer just to add a little bit of shine.